रेडी स्टार्ट। बीइंग एग्रीव्ड बाय द सेड अवार्ड ऑफ द लेबर कोर्ट द फर्स्ट रिस्पोंडेंट हियर इन प्रिफर्ड अ रिट पिटीशन बिफोर अ लर्नेड सिंगल जज ऑफ द गुवाहाटी हाई कोर्ट हु आफ्टर हियरिंग द पार्टीज केम टू द कंक्लूजन दैट द फाइंडिंग ऑफ द लेबर कोर्ट दैट देयर वॉज एक्सटॉर्शन ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट्स बाय द वर्कमैन कंसर्न्ड वॉज कॉन्ट्रेरी टू द चार्जशीट विच डिड नॉट कंटेन सच एन एलिगेशन इट केम टू द कंक्लूजन दैट एलिगेशन ऑफ एक्सटॉर्शन वॉज एन आफ्टर थॉट इट ऑल्सो एक्सेप्टेड द डिफेंस ऑफ द वर्कमैन दैट दे इंटर्ड द ई स्टेट ओनली टू ऑब्टेन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द इंजर्ड वर्कमैन who was assaulted by the manager of the estate. It also held that the labor court did not apply its mind to the vital facts and circumstances of the case, as alleged by the learned counsel for the workmen who appeared in the said writ petition. On that basis, the learned single judge came to the conclusion that the labor court did not appreciate the material on record properly and passed the order justifying the dismissal which is disproportionate to the offense alleged. It also held that the court were honorably acquitted by the criminal court and the departmental inquiry held by the management was faulty. On the said basis, it set aside the award and directed the management to reinstate the serving workmen who have not attained the age of superannuation with compensation of ₹15,000 to each of them in lieu of back wages and to pay compensation of ₹30,000 to each of the workers who have superannuated during the pendency of the proceedings and to fix lump sum compensation in consultation with the petitioner, which shall be paid to the actual heir of the workmen who expired without getting any benefit. It directed the management to pay the said compensation within 6 weeks from the receipt of its judgment. Sri R. K. Chaudhary, learned senior counsel addressing arguments on behalf of the appellant, contended that the labor court having permitted the parties to adduce evidence in justification or otherwise of the finding of the domestic tribunal and having recorded evidence in this regard justly came to the conclusion that the management has established its case of misconduct against the workmen. He also contended that the finding in regard to the extortion of the documents was not actually a new charge but was in fact a part of the charge which referred to the wrongful confinement of the manager and there being sufficient material before the labor court both in regard to the long and wrongful confinement of the manager and other officials of the estate as also in regard to the forceful extortion of the document agreeing to pay 20% bonus, the labor court was justified in coming to the conclusion that the workmen were also guilty of the said charge of extortion and the original charge as framed by the domestic inquiry having clearly stated about the wrongful confinement of the manager of the estate.